Hey guys, Kellen again, and in today's video, I want to talk about a money mindset change that will change your life. So by watching this video, you are going to completely change your relationship with money, especially as it relates to time. So stay tuned, I can't wait to share. So you probably saw the thumbnail and the title of this video, and you're probably very curious, Kellen, what are you talking about? We don't buy things with money.
Seriously.
Of course we do. I just bought a latte this morning on my way to work with a $5 bill. I just upgraded my phone last weekend to the newest iPhone and I paid with my credit card, which is money that I had. Or I just upgraded my car at the dealership and I used a credit card or I took out a loan. That's money. We are buying things with money. So what are you talking about? So let me share a quote from Henry David Thoreau. The true price of anything is the amount of time that you exchange for it. So listen to that again. The true price of anything is the amount of time you exchange for it. It helps us better understand the weight of our purchases and the actual cost of purchasing them. So let me share a couple of examples of everyday purchases to help you visualize what this mindset change actually looks like, to help you visualize how much time you're giving away with everyday purchases that we all make. To keep things simple, we're gonna use an average American that's making $60,000 a year. They're working 40-hour work weeks, which comes out to around $30 an hour. So here's the amount of time you need to trade for some of these everyday purchases. The first one is a large Dunkin' Donuts coffee for $4. You're gonna have to trade away 8 minutes of your time. The next purchase is a nice pair of Wrangler jeans for $40 that you found on sale that you have to trade away 80 minutes of work to afford. A Coach purse for $120 is gonna be a whole half day of work. A new 70-inch flat screen LCD TV is gonna be, for $600, is going to be 2.5 days of work. The newest iPhone for $1,000 to upgrade is going to be over 4 days of work. A nice dinner with your family of four is going to cost you around $80. It's almost a half day's of work. A nice home-cooked meal is going to save you a lot of money. $15, that's only a half an hour of work. A brand new living room set that costs you $2,000 is going to cost you 1 week and a little bit over 3 days. A brand new Ford F-150 that runs about $30,000 is going to cost you over 5 months of work. All right, now I have ones that are a little bit more complicated with housing. So a 2,500 square foot house with a 10% down payment, 30-year mortgage at 4%, $300,000 purchase price, so your total lifetime cost is $464,000 and some change. You are going to have to work 7 years, 9 months.
I am dead inside.
Compared to a house that's 1,600 square feet with a 15% down payment, 30-year mortgage, 4% interest, $180,000 purchase price, total cost of $262,960 is only going to be 4 years, 5 months of work. And don't forget to add taxes, your work commute, extra meetings, overtime into the mix, and this exercise becomes even more mind-blowing. And of course, there are better alternatives to use your time than going to work at a job you probably don't enjoy, just to come home and buy material items that have a little bit of gratification up front that fade very quickly, like all material items do. You can focus on things that are far more important, such as, it only takes 1 minute to kiss your spouse, to hug your spouse, to do a little dance with them in the kitchen, and to show them how much you truly appreciate and love them. It only takes 5 minutes to have fun with your kids and play a hot game of hide and go seek or tag around the house. It takes 10 minutes to read them a bedtime story and sing them some songs. It only takes 30 minutes to get outside and get fit and healthy and go on a family walk. It only takes about an hour to help your kids with homework. It takes maybe 1 or 2 hours to volunteer your time in the community, at your local soup kitchen, at your church, to really feel fulfilled and useful in life. The money that we earn is ours to keep and we can spend it however we want, but doing an exercise like this really helps you understand how much precious time we are giving away with each purchase we make. The harsh reality is that we are all going to die. Time is by far our most valuable asset in life. If you ask anyone that's on their deathbed or close to death, what they wish they had more in life, it would be time. They would not tell you they want more money. They would tell you they wanted more time to spend with their family, to make an impact, to pursue their dreams, to really be fulfilled and useful in life. So it's always important to remember we can use our time to pursue things with far greater value than any material item we'll ever bring in our life. So before I end, I do want to go over a few closing final thoughts that I have that are gonna help you take action from this video and implement it into your life. Number one is just reiterating that time is by far our most valuable asset in life, far greater than any money will ever be. So make sure you are using your precious time the way you want to. That's going to bring you the most happiness and fulfillment in life. Number two, the next time you go to purchase something, instead of looking at the price tag, convert it to how much time it will take you at work or on your business. to purchase that item. That mindset change is going to be huge in helping you stop impulse buying and making sure that you are purchasing items that are actually going to bring value to your life long term. Number three is, because time is such a valuable asset, you need to start learning how to create multiple passive streams of income. So whether that's through a business or investing your money into the stock market, you need to be putting your money to work so that you're not always trading your time for money. You need to break away from, that's the only way I can make money, is go to work, get a paycheck, trade your time for money. You have to stop that. You have to experience and understand other ways of making money and putting your money to work, investing your money so you can create passive streams of income and make money while you're sleeping. Number four is that happiness can really be broken down into three things: your health and fitness, your family and your relationships. So how good are your relationships with your family members and your friends? Do you love people? Do they love you back? That is huge in life. Do you have a good relationship with God? Does he love you? Do you love him? And number three is freedom. And it's freedom with your time. It's freedom with your money. It's freedom to pursue what you want to pursue and have the happiness and joy of fulfillment of being able to pursue that. Not being tied down to a job you don't like. It's the freedom to kind of navigate and do what you want with your time. So instead of focusing on those material items that give you a shot of dopamine and a little bit of instant gratification and slowly fade away, focus on those three pillars of happiness: your health, your family and your relationships, and your freedom, and you will be far more fulfilled and receive long-term happiness in life. Number five is, if you are financing your life away with a new car, the new gadget, maxing out your credit cards by impulse spending, it's the surefire way to always be having to force yourself to go to work, make a paycheck to try to pay yourself out of debt. So be smart, focus on those three pillars of happiness, focus on converting your time into money when making big purchases, especially big purchases, to really open up and have that mindset of, I'm gonna have to put in this much work in order to afford this item that I wanna buy, and you're gonna be well on your way to a much happier and more fulfilled life. So that's the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the thumbs up before you leave. It helps the YouTube algorithm quite a bit. And please make sure you're subscribed. There's like 95% of you that are watching this video. So please hit the subscribe for more savvy videos. We will catch you on the next one. Peace.